Galesburg, Illinois has been a major railroading hotspot for many years, as it features multiple main lines going through the town, as well as a major classification yard. With Galesburg being such a big railroad town, it has also been home to a number of model railroaders, as well as a model railroad club. This club is the Illinois Midland Model Railroad Club. The club owned an HO scale layout, which was located in the center court of the Carl Sandburg Mall. Measuring about 350 square feet, the layout is modeled to capture the look and feel of the Illinois countryside in the early 1960s on a fictional railroad known as the Illinois Midland. The layout's history, as well as the history of the club that ran the layout, are just as fascinating as the layout itself. Here to explain some of the history behind the layout is two club members. Ron Hatch explains how this all began. So, how did the mall layout come into being?
About the January of 1988, the mall manager approached me, asked about doing a railroad display in one of the planters that used to be in Center Court. And she had ideas like the Gilbert Railroad Yards, this and that, and this was a task I didn't want to take on solo, so I enlisted the aid of Ron Kofer, who was an engineer on the PEM, and we actually came up with a plan to fit the planter. And the idea was to build this over a year and a half span, and have the grand opening railroad days 1989. But Ron Kofer had some time on his hands, and we recruited some members from the Galesburg Model Railroad Club. And so next thing I know, Ron Kofer's saying, we can have this done for this year's railroad days. So we signed the contracts, started building. Ron used to have a hobby shop, so he still had his wholesale connections. 88 days later, we had a model railroad in the center court and had our unveiling at the opening ceremonies for the 1988 Galesburg Railroad Days. Now, the railroad itself was built in one of the empty stores at the end of the old Sears Court. To bring it down and put it where it was, we had to fit it around the column. And the three pieces of the layout would not go down the center court flat because of the kiosks. Wouldn't go on a forklift. It was big and bulky, so the way it was moved down there is we got in contact with all the local gyms, a bunch of bodybuilders. They came out and moved the layout because it had to be horsed around, tilted, this, that, and the other thing. Set it in place for us so we could make the final connections. The cost for that endeavor was all the beer and pizza these guys could hold.
Club member Tom Anderson explains what happened between 1986 and 2014 and how the new club was formed.
It was maintained by the mall and that, with help from some model railroaders and that, but the problem was that they were burning up engines. They would turn the layout on in the morning and run it all day, all night, until the mall shut down, and they were melting one or two engines a week. So it went into disrepair. Several people took a shot at it, but it was approximately 2017, 16, 15. So around December of 2014, Mike Allen and myself were members of the museum in Galesburg, the Railroad Museum, and we were approached and asking if we would be willing to possibly get the mall layout up back up and running again. And so we started working on it, seeing what we could do in that, and then we had an article that was published, I think it was in December or January of 2015, and out of that we got a bunch of people interested, came forward, and then we formed the Illinois Midland Model Railroad.
Almost all of the locomotives and rolling stock that you will be seeing are owned by the various club members. While most equipment is from the 1950s and 60s, you will be seeing more modern locomotives and rolling stock throughout this program. As with train watching in Galesburg itself, the variety in locomotives and rolling stock is diverse and very surprising, and you never know what will turn up on the Illinois Midland. So sit back and enjoy the sights of the many trains that appeared on the Illinois Midland from 2015 to 2017.
Thank you. line is a mighty good road. Rock Island Line is the road to ride. Rock Island Line is a mighty good road. If you want to ride it, got a ticket like you find it. Buy a ticket at the station on the Rock Island Line.
Sadly, it was just too good to last. In late 2016, rumors regarding the demolition and closing of the Sandbrook Mall started circulating around. The Illinois Midland Model Railroad Club made the decision to move out of the Sandbrook Mall and find a new home. After looking at various locations in and around Galesburg, which didn't suit their needs, they eventually moved into the Alexis Fieldhouse in Alexis, Illinois, located in the former Alexis High School building. On September 11th, 2017, the last train ran on the Illinois Midland. On September 13th, the Illinois Midland Model Railroad in the Sandbrook Mall was completely dismantled. Everything that could be salvaged off of the layout that hadn't already been removed was taken over to Alexis. Many boxes of scenery items and buildings were also taken out from underneath the layout. The club's new layout has been under construction since July of 2017, and the layout has been finished since then, but work is still continuing on it to make it complete as this DVD is being made. And the club usually meets on Wednesday nights as well as Sunday afternoons. The Illinois Midland Model Railroad Club also has its own Facebook page, which will have operating hours posted there, as well as photos regularly showing updates of the layout. Announcements for train shows being hosted by the club will also be posted here. So if you're ever in the Galesburg area, or anywhere near Alexis for that matter, why not stop by? Thank you for watching this DVD, and please stay tuned for bonus material.
model was designed to depict a slice of Illinois circa 1960. It would cover an area of nearly 1,000 square feet and weigh over 3,000 pounds. Each piece on the model was built to HO scale, right down to the 300 hand-painted half-inch tall people that populated the three tiny cities. Sandburg Station would be a city of about 20,000. River City would be a typical small city on the banks of a river in Illinois. Knox would be a village in decline. The layout was constructed from 1,200 board feet of number 2 pine, 450 square feet of screen, 300 pounds of plaster, and 75 rolls of paper towels. The physical characteristics of the model are impressive. 400 feet of rail, 16,000 cross ties, 22 diesel locomotives, and 81 freight cars.
Basically, we're the ones responsible for coming up with the idea of Illinois Midland. We wanted to pick a road that was familiar to everybody, yet really was non-existent, so we didn't have to follow a prototype. Ron and I have just kicked around different names.
Since this is supposed to be representative of Illinois, the heartland of the country, the heart of Illinois, why not Illinois Midland?
Yeah, we kind of stole it a little bit.
There is a railroad called the Chicago and Illinois Midland. C-M-I-L. Now this is a railroad that Ron
Yeah, I've been interested for years, and since it isn't very big, very few people have heard about it. And we just kind of thought if we shortened it a little bit and made it from being a short line to being a Class 1 style carrier, and kind of let our fantasies run wild, that we'd create a very believable effect. And I think we have. Mr. Hatch has, but designing all the logos, such as real-life the Wabash Railroad, no longer exists. Of course, their cars look like this, with their own emblem, their own reporting marks, and their own name. Ron came up with the Illinois Midland the same way. Very similar style, their own separate logo. And when it's blended in and there's a high percentage of Illinois Midland cars, it looks very realistic and it creates the illusion that the Illinois Midland really exists in real life, when the only place it exists is in our minds.
Sarasota, Sanford Mill.
That's right.
The other advantage of Illinois Midland is cow sets are commercially available for the Chicago and Illinois Midland. I made up dry transfers for the freight equipment. For the passenger equipment, Ron had some CNIM cow sets. It's very handy, knocked off the Chicago and which had left is Illinois Midland. So that worked out fairly handy also.
And all our locomotives are done that way. The color scheme we decided to pick for the Illinois Midland was we wanted something local. We used the high school colors of yellow and black, except we just changed it into a more railroad motif, which is really Rio Grande gold and ancient black.
It's kind of a cross between the Milwaukee Road scheme, the Western Pacific scheme, the Rio Grande scheme, and whatever else we felt like throwing in really.
Yeah, so it still creates the illusion. I've seen that somewhere before, but nobody can ever tell you where because it never existed before.
The whole concept was to make it believable. It is a fictitious road, but to those who don't really know railroads that well, for all they know, it could be a real railroad. Thank you.
Spike Odell are going to drive the last golden spike into the railroad. And then Ron Hatch and Jackie Kahn are going to prior.
Thank you.